Hello everybody and welcome to Gazi's X-Ray. Today I'm going to show you how to root with chain fires method. First we need to go to about and look for build and press it 7 times until we become a developer. And let's choose developer options and enable USB debugging by choosing on. Awesome, so let's go back to the computer and download the files from the description. We'll start with the drivers. Let's plug in our USB cable to the computer. The Nexus player will be installing. Okay, once it's done, we need to update the drivers so they can function correctly. Just look for Android on other devices and click on browse and another time browse. And let's look for the extracted file, USB driver, and okay. Next, install. And we're set. Now we need to extract the roots folder. And let's open ADB. And you can find this in the description as well. And type in ADB devices so we can look for our device. If we type in ADB reboot bootloader, it wouldn't find any device unless we accept the message we see in the TV. So let's go back to TV and click on allow and okay. All right, now we can type in ADB devices again. And we're connected. So now we need to either copy on or type ADB reboot bootloader. Our Nexus player will be rebooting to the recovery, or actually the fast boot. Awesome, we're in. Okay, now we need to head to the computer and unlock the bootloader by typing fast boot OEM unlock first time, and then one more time. This process might take a little bit of time, so we need to be patient, and you have to know that everything will be erased at this point. And it's unlocked. Congrats. So first we need to root our device. We can type in fast boot space and look for the folder path / roots. If I can type in roots.img and just press enter and it will do all the necessary work. Okay, so now we need to connect our controller or remote control by pressing the two buttons. And we're connected. We need to do the initial setup one more time. And once you're finished, you can go and look for SuperSU. Click on continue. And normal. This will take care of the setup of Super SU, and this will restart. If you like Change Fire's work and the root method, please consider donating money to him. And click on OK, actually reboot. All right, so we're rooted and we have the Super SU application. I went away and installed Sideload Launcher. If you're interested how to sideload XBMC or any other app, there is a video in the description showing you how to do it. And everything seems to be functional. If you guys like this video and interested about more like these, please subscribe. Take care.